without trying to be seen and heard at the same time. You got to be able to be seen to where people take a second look, like, whoa, who's that? You know what I mean? What does he do? A lot of people look at me and they come up to me when I'm not even, when I'm just out shopping or something, and would be like, hey, you know, what kind of work do you do? Are you an artist? Like, are you an actor? Like, you know, like they just see that type of vibe and energy in my parents. And I think that's cool. So, you know, it's just something I'm used to. You know, I've been doing this for a long time now. So I'm very comfortable with just approaching people, signing autographs, taking pictures, even at times when I don't want to. Like, it's funny because, like, at one time I'm using the restroom and I come out and there's like three girls outside, like, please, can I have a picture with you? I'm like, whoa, you know, can a brother wash his hands first? It's just kind of crazy, but that's just how it gets sometimes. You know, sometimes I'll be eating and someone comes to the table and is like, you know, can I have a picture with you? It would be nice if they could wait until I'm done eating. But I feel like my job is to be of service to the public, because the public is who even allows me the opportunity to be sitting in that restaurant affording a meal. Without their support, I wouldn't be able to do that. So, even though it'd be nice to just take the picture when I'm done eating, I would stop, take the picture, get it out the way, go back to enjoy my meal. Nobody else can compare to you. I expect that there will be challenges, and I treat them all the same. It's just another obstacle to get right over. You know, I laugh in the face of my challenges and I turn them into opportunities. So whether I'm going to the Civico to go spend some time behind bars in jail, or whether or not somebody confronts me that's drunk and belligerent and being rude and disrespectful to, you know, somebody trying to rob me and pick my pocket. It's like all kind of different challenges. Just gotta be ready for whatever, you know. I'm traveling on unfamiliar territory, different countries.
Pack it up, wind it up, make it bounce, make it drop. That you run the dance, gotta step on top. You got it locked and under control.
In Broken Dreams, when you saw me getting hauled off to jail, it's because when you're in Mexico, there are certain parts that you're not allowed to promote your music in the streets without the proper permits. And if you don't have those permits, then you just gotta face the consequences. I don't have those permits, but I don't think it's that serious that it should stop me from doing what I need to do. I just have to deal with the situation and deal with the consequences as they come. So if I gotta go to jail and deal with that, then I go to jail and deal with that. I'm cool with it, you know. I do what I gotta do to get myself to where I need to go.
Wind it up, wind it up, baby, just wind it up. Hey, when I say wind, wind it up for me.
Yeah, man, well, with me taking my music to different parts of the world where people wouldn't necessarily normally listen to my genre of music, punta, soca, reggae, and so forth, you know, I feel like music is universal. And I'm, you know, me delivering it to this region and this part of the world where people don't even speak the language is proof in the pudding. You know what I mean? When I could come out to Mexico and I could sell 400 CDs every day, it confirms to me that music is universal. That, you know, people might not speak the language, but when you play that music, it opens doors, it opens hearts, it opens one's imagination, it opens one's wallet, it opens one, you know, bank account. So, hey, I'm just here to do what I do. Take this music places it never has been. Introduce it to people that most people would say would have never bought a CD of that genre. What's next? I don't know what country I'm gonna go to next at this moment. I don't know where I'm gonna be at in the next couple of months or whatever, but I'm either thinking about going to Cancun to go promote on that side in Quintana Roo, or going to Tijuana, and I'm being closer to the border. So I'm thinking about just promoting my music at the Tijuana border, which is one of the most busiest borders in the world. So, you know, they have over 1 million cars that pass through the Tijuana, San Diego border, and I'm thinking about just pushing my music there for a few, see how that vibe is, and then return back to Belize for a couple of weeks, enjoy some time with my family, hit the road again. This is what I do. Make things happen, taking this music around the world, you know. Just living the life of an artist. Sometimes good, sometimes bad, but I love it all, so I enjoy it to the fullest. It's what I do, baby.
Yeah, look at the good, you just got it like that. Natural beauty, you got it like that. Pretty fierce, sexy booty, you got it like that. Every man want wife, you got it like that.
The Mixed Feelings Tour has been a wonderful one for me. And I have to say, some of the most memorable moments for me would be like when this one lady who was like 90-something years old, as a matter of fact, she was 94, and she was with her husband, who was 96, and they were actually walking down the street, walking on Madeira, which is a very, very busy street. And it was so cool. I've never seen anyone that old walking on the street. And not only were they old, they look it. You know what I mean? The funny part is they look very old, but they were happy. And the old man walks up to me and asks me, how much is my CD? And when I told him, I guess it wasn't within his budget, but this guy, everybody's watching anyway, but this guy that was close enough to hear them ask the question, he said, if you want one, I'll give it. Because he was just intrigued, I guess, to see this old couple, they walking and they winding up, dancing. And he wants to like buy a CD. It wasn't within his budget, so the next guy bought it for him. I was gonna give it to him free anyway, because I just thought that was so cool and so cool. That was just so cute. You know, see this old couple walking all happy, and he's dancing, and him and his wife is dancing, and the guy buys the CD for them, and I signed the CD. He shook my hand, wanted a hug, and he walks away dancing with his CD and holding it up, and took a picture with me before he left. And he felt, you know, this whole thing was just like very exciting to me, when people come up to me in wheelchairs and, you know, wants a picture and a hug and a CD. It's really, you know, it's very big to me. You know, when you see this little girl, she was like 3 years old, but she looked like she was way younger. And the mom says that, hey, she wants to take a picture with you. Would you please take a picture with her? And she is like, you know, of course she said it in Spanish. And the little girl said, sí, yo quiero foto contigo. I thought that was so beautiful and so cute. And I text a picture with her and she poses and do her hand like that. You know, I think it's just so amazing.
Baby,
2 years from now, I see myself doing bigger things. I see me going more places, exploring more countries. You know, hopefully I can go to other countries that never heard of my music or never even know of Berne, and just introduce myself to the people, whether it be on the television, on the radio station, or in the streets. I'm ready for whatever. I'm built for war, so I'm here to take this music to places that it has never been. And I'm good with that.
Surely had a wonderful time dancing with you. I must say I feel good. Until next time. I'm out.